afternoon, folks. Steve Rhodes coming to you live from the shores of Delray Beach, Florida. This is your 1 p.m. update. And currently, we have a slightly mixed bag out here. That mixed bag is with the transports and the semis off just slightly. They're basically flat, but they are just a slightly negative. The Dow's up 43. S&P's up 8. NASDAQ 157 points. The Russell 2000 is a big leader today, percentage-wise, up about 0.9% or 19 points out there. You've got gold up 0.5%. That's $9. Silver's up 20 pennies. That's 0.9%. Lightsweet crude up 0.5% or 38 cents. Trading out at $76.94. Let's go spend a little time with our nine panel market update chart. We begin by taking a look at the ES Mini. That's in the upper left-hand corner. Today is going to become bar number 6 of a TD9 count. So the only topping signals that we have, because price is above all resistance levels, TD9 count areas, TAS market profiles. So the only potential topping signal at the moment would be a TD9 count top that would take place sometime in the middle of next week. That's likely to occur because we have that spot volatility still below its 50-day exponential moving average, suggesting that it wants to target the lower Bollinger band at 1527. NASDAQ 100, interestingly enough, or the NQ, has not taken out its Rhodes Momentum Indicator top. That's the high from the trading day of November 22nd. That level would be 16,769.25. The U.S. dollar index, you can see, just consolidating with inside its daily profile level. Gold, as we've talked about yesterday, it has been able to stay above the top of its daily profile. That's at 1802. That suggests a run to the 1828 level. The case of silver. Silver already has a sell the D point pattern, but price may go target its high from a few days ago, that bearish shooting star in the 2346 level. Lightsweet crude has got an A to B equals CD to the upside. What this needs in order to cement some type of a top would be a bearish reversal candle. Short of that, lightsweet crude should go target 79.95. If we take a look at natural gas, just struggling. It has a buy the D point pattern, but it is suspect. Suspect because price cannot take out that gap down resistance level of $3.98. And if we take a look at 30-year Treasury, although it was trading just slightly below the bottom of its daily profile, you can see it found support at its little rising trend line. If you can't bust them down, may try to bust them up in the case of the 30-year Treasury. That could be sending a signal that wants to make a move to the 161.09 level. Folks, stay tuned for the Trader's Edge Show. But if you're off to start your Thursday, have a terrific one. Have a happy new year. And we'll see you soon.